In this video, we're continuing on with the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, Dividing Rational Expressions. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Picking up where we left off with number 9, we need to remember that when dividing a rational, we're going to be multiplying by the reciprocal of that fraction. So number 9, I'm going to rewrite as 7a squared over 7a cubed plus 56a squared times, flipping this fraction, a squared plus 7a minus 8 all over 2. Now let's simplify. I cannot simplify the numerator of my first fraction, so I'll leave that as 7a squared. However, for my denominator, I'll be able to pull out a 7a squared from each of the terms. Pulling out 7a squared, I'll multiply that by the quantity a plus 8. And that's because 7a squared times a is 7a cubed, and 7a squared times 8 is 56a squared. So that fraction will be multiplied to, simplifying my second fraction, that numerator I will see what two numbers multiply to give me negative 8 and add to give me positive 7. Well, if we look at the factors of 8, that will be 1 and 8, where the 1 is negative, because negative 1 times 8 is a negative 8, and negative 1 plus 8 is a positive 7. So rewriting a squared plus 7a minus 8 as a minus 1 times a plus 8, I'll then write that over the denominator, which is 2. Now you can see that I have a lot to simplify. 7a squared divided by 7a squared is 1, and a plus 8 divided by a plus 8 is 1. So I have a minus 1 over 2 as my solution in number 9, because I have a minus 1 still in my numerator and 2 is the only number left in my denominator. A minus 1 over 2. Moving on to number 10, I'll rewrite as 6 over 28x plus 4, and it will get multiplied by flipping this fraction, known as the reciprocal of that fraction, 35x plus 5 over 6. Right away, I'll be able to cancel out my 6s because 6 divided by 6 is 1. So in my numerator, I'll have 35x plus 5, and in my denominator, I'll have 28x plus 4. Now, 35x and 5 are both divisible by 5, and 28x and 4 are both divisible by 4. So pulling out a 5 from my numerator, I'll get 7x plus 1 as that quantity within parentheses. 5 times 7x is 35x, and 5 times 1 is 5. Now, pulling out a 4 in my denominator, I'll also have 7x plus 1 as the quantity within my parentheses, because 4 times 7x is 28x, and 4 times 1 is 4. 7x plus 1 will cancel out with 7x plus 1 to leave me with 5/4 as my solution in number 10. Let's continue on to that second page. Now, in number 11, I'm going to simplify as I rewrite our expression. I'm going to see what two numbers multiply to give me 16 and add to give me 10. The factors of 16 that will work are 2 and 8, where both 2 and 8 are positive, because 2 plus 8 is a positive 10, and 2 times 8 is a positive 16. So rewriting that quadratic as x plus 2 times x plus 8, essentially rewriting that quadratic in factored form, now I'm going to rewrite my denominator. What two numbers multiply to give me 8 and add to give me a positive 6? The factors of 8 will be 2 and 4, because 2 times 4 is 8 and 2 plus 4 is 6. So rewriting that quadratic as x plus 2 times x plus 4. That first rational or first fraction will get multiplied to the reciprocal of the other fraction since it's divided. So flipping that fraction, I'll have x plus 4 in my numerator and 1 in my denominator. So now let's cancel out. X plus 2 divided by x plus 2 is 1, and x plus 4 will cancel out with the x plus 4 in the denominator. So all I'll have left is x plus 8 in my numerator over 1 in my denominator, which is x plus 8. That is my solution in number 11. In number 12, again, I'm going to simplify as I go along. So 49x plus 21, I can pull out a 7 from both 49x and 21. So pulling out that 7, I'll have 7x plus 3 remaining in my numerator, because 7 times 7x is 49x, and 7 times 3 is 21, and that's all over 6x. Now I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal of my second fraction, which is 6 over 42x plus 18. However, I'm going to rewrite 42x plus 18 because I can pull out a 6 from each of the terms. Pulling out a 6, I'll get 7x plus 3 as the quantity within my parentheses, because 6 times 7x is 42x, and 6 times 3 is 18. Now simplifying, my 6 in my numerator will cancel out with a 6 in my denominator, so it can cancel out with either 6. It can cancel out with the 6 that's with 6x, or it can cancel out with the 6 that's with 7x plus 3. It doesn't matter because multiplication is commutative. Also note that 7x plus 3 will cancel out with 7x plus 3. So I'll have 7 over 6x as my solution in number 12. In number 13, I'm not going to simplify, I'm just going to rewrite. So 7 over 8r minus 40 times 8r minus 40 over 1. And I didn't simplify 8r minus 40 because I already have 8r minus 40, so I can just cancel out those terms. 8r minus 40 in the numerator will cancel out with 8r minus 40 in the denominator, so I'll have 7 over 1, which is equal to 7. So 7 is my solution in number 13. Now, if you wanted to simplify, you could have pulled out an 8 from 8r minus 40 to get 8 times r minus 5. However, then you would have also simplified this to be 8 times r minus 5, and they would have still have canceled out. In number 14, I'll start by rewriting. So I'll have 1 over 2a times the reciprocal of our second fraction, which is 2a squared plus 16a all over 8a. Now I'm going to simplify the numerator of our second fraction, which used to be the denominator. So I'll have 1 over 2a times, pulling out a 2a from each of those terms, I'll get a plus 8, because 2a times a is 2a squared, and 2a times 8 is 16a. So 2a times the quantity 8 plus a over 8a. Now, my 2a in my numerator will cancel out with my 2a in my denominator, and when I multiply my numerators, I'll get a plus 8 over, multiply my denominator, 8a. A plus 8 over 8a is my solution in number 14. In number 15, I'll simplify as I rewrite. So I'll have 8 over 4n squared minus 16n. I can pull out 4n from each of those terms. So pulling out 4n, I'll have n minus 4 within those parentheses, because 4n times n is 4n squared, and 4n times 4 is 16n, and there's subtraction between. So 8 over 4n times n minus 4 will get multiplied by the reciprocal of this fraction, which is n minus 4 over 1. And it's multiplied by the reciprocal because we were dividing. So now let's simplify. N minus 4 will cancel out with n minus 4, so we'll have 8 over 4n. However, both 8 and 4 are divisible by 4. 8 divided by 4 is 2, and 4 divided by 4 is 1, and 1 times n is n. So 2 over n is our solution in number 15. Moving on to number 16, I'll have a minus 4 over, simplifying this quadratic and simplifying by factoring, I'm going to see what two numbers multiply to give me negative 8 and add to give me negative 2. So the factors of 8 will be 2 and 4, where the 4 is negative, because 2 times negative 4 is negative 8, and 2 plus negative 4 is negative 2. So rewriting a squared minus 2a minus 8 as a plus 2 times a minus 4, I will be multiplying that fraction or that rational to the reciprocal of our second fraction, which will be a minus 5 over 1. So now canceling out the terms that are the same in the numerator and denominator, I have a minus 4 and a minus 4. And I can cancel those out because a minus 4 divided by a minus 4 is 1. And 1 times any quantity is the quantity that you're multiplying 1 by. So 1 is multiplied by a minus 5 over a plus 2. So a minus 5 over a plus 2 is my solution in number 16. And it's going to be the final solution in this video. If you have any questions or just want to leave me a note, put it in the comments below. Before continuing on to the next video where I'll finish out this worksheet, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.